My name is Colt. I'm 33 years old. I live in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Oh, you look so beautiful.
I work as a software engineer, and I live with my cats, baby girl, cookie dough, and sugar.
Colt, breakfast.
And my mother, Debbie. My mother cooks for me, does my laundry and whatever, and she will drive me to work and pick me up because we only have one vehicle. You could say I'm a bit of a mommy's boy. Hey, Mom.
Morning.
How'd you sleep?
Good. How about you?
Pretty good. Ever since my father passed 10 years ago, we've been very close and we've taken care of each other. We've been living together more or less since I was born. She loves me with all of her heart. I'm her baby boy, and I love her. Baby girl wants breakfast, too.
Baby girl has a tendency to join the family here.
Keep saying we should get a plate for her, like a little seat. They make cat seats for like that?
No.
We should invent one.
Colt and I have been having breakfast together for over 30 years.
Are you finished?
Yeah. Very good.
I definitely spoil Colt by doing everything around the house. I don't think he even knows how to make a bed.
In my spare time, I enjoy fixing things. Maybe breaking things more often. I spend most of my free time alone with my cats.
What are you doing? Wanna play video games?
You could say I'm more of an introvert. I never thought I would get married. All my previous relationships have ended with me getting a broken heart. After having struck out a few times online with American girls, I thought maybe I could search outside the country, maybe find a girl, and then I met Larissa. Larissa lives in Brazil, and she's 31 years old. I had sent Larissa a message, and to my surprise, she actually responded, and we started talking. It wasn't long before I decided I really wanted to meet her in person. So we worked it out and decided to meet in Cancun, Mexico. When I got to the airport in Mexico, Larissa walked around the corner. I saw her in, like, slow motion. I thought I was having a heart attack. She was the most beautiful woman I've ever seen. I was like, I'm done, this is it. It was like all the boxes were checked. She's beautiful, she's smart, and she seemed pretty cool with the idea of me living with my mother. After 5 days, I knew that I wanted to spend the rest of my life with her. So as we were leaving for the airport, I decided to propose to her. And she said yes. I was a little surprised. I'm sure she must have a lot of suitors back in Brazil. But I think that she was looking for someone kind of geeky, and maybe she wants to be a little adventurous. Larissa's K-1 visa was approved, and I booked her flight to arrive tomorrow. But Larissa currently does not have her visa in hand. I miss you.
I miss you too, honey.
You look so beautiful tonight.
Thank you. You look handsome.
Oh, thank you, darling.
But just to be careful with your bangs.
Well, it's been a very long day, darling.
Yeah.
Honey, tell me, please, the visa, did you get it?
Unfortunately, not yet. I think that you have to pick the next flight that you can.
We have no guarantee of the visa to arrive tomorrow or Monday. I can't make a ticket, have the change fee, and make another ticket. You understand? It costs money, a fee, to do so.
I see, but a lot of money or less money?
Well, it's going to be a healthy amount, a healthy size. I think Larissa has a false understanding of life in America. Not everyone is a millionaire. Maybe she thinks I just have a lot of money in the bank or under the mattress or something.
The only logical solution is to delay the trip.
No, baby.
Especially for like such a short time, it doesn't make any sense.
To me, it makes sense because I wish I could be with you.
I know you're disappointed, and I'm very sorry for that, but...
You want to, but you hurt me because I thought that you will feel like, oh my God, I'm sad.
I
need Larissa here. I make plans with her.
You did make plans.
And you were so rational, like...
What do you want me to do, cry? You want me to roll up in a ball and cry and go to bed weeping? Write in my diary and how sad I am, but it's merely a week, probably less than a week. We've been apart for a very long time.
I don't think rescheduling for a few hours is reasonable. I think waiting an extra few days is more logical and a better solution to our problem.
I'm quite tired, to be honest with you. I've had a very long week.
Okay, baby, we're waiting. I miss you, but have a good night.
Good night, darling. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
She seemed a little distant. I would say she's definitely more emotional and I'm more rational. And I think that's an interesting dynamic that may present problems moving ahead.